get to be partners with the same person from BNN today.
I know.
How special is that?
It's exciting. It's a beautiful day here today. It's about 60 degrees. Really nice for Oswego, about middle of the summer.
Absolutely, as we got both teams from Oswego County competing in the girls lacrosse.
It should be a good day for the Bucks to come out and get a win. A lot of the girls seem really excited about the game. And before the game, there's going to be a memorial.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Hills of Wilbur Field. And welcome to tonight's Section 3 matchup between the Central Square Red Hawks and your Oswego Buccaneers. Ladies and gentlemen, the New York State Public High School Athletic Association encourages all spectators to enjoy the competition between our student athletes and to cheer for other teams in a positive manner. Negative comments and behavior will be addressed by the appropriate site personnel. Spectators should be loud, proud, and positive toward players, coaches, officials, and fellow spectators. Section 3 reminds you that the use of artificial noisemakers is strictly forbidden. Thank you for your support and enjoy the game.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to the game. It is nearly impossible to put the magnitude of our loss into words. We had to say goodbye to a woman who is not only our athletic trainer, but our biggest cheerleader, our friend, and a mother to all. Her dedication and love for us went far beyond just treating injuries. Michelle always said she had hundreds of kids, and she loved all of us as if we were her own. Wink made it her goal in life to make people happy. Her kindness was contagious, and everyone was touched by it and her infectious smile. Her never-ending Buck pride, personal nicknames, and fierce love for the Tar Heels will never be forgotten. Wink's presence was undeniable. She was truly a gift to each and every one of us, and we are blessed to have felt her love. Anyone who knew Michelle knows she would have wanted to be sad over what we've lost. She wants to come together and reminisce about all the great times we had with her. The sound of Michelle's voice as she yelled my name across the gym will forever ring in my head and in my heart, but I choose to focus on the sweet memories I will always have of her. In honor of Michelle, my teammates and I would like to dedicate this game to her. We'd like for everyone to use this as an opportunity to come together as a community and heal. We love you, Wayne. This one's for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, will you please stand and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
Yeah.
6, April Christodoulou. On attack, number 7, Alex Keys. On attack, number 23, Delaney Turtura. Midfielder, number 21, Corky Fox. Midfielder, number 3, Alexis Grant. Midfielder, number 11, Emma Robinson. On defense, number 20, Lauren Bell. On defense, number 5, Sam Simakula. On defense, number 8, Shannon Fisher. On defense, number 18, Nora Salander. And in the goal, number 32, Megan Phillips. The Red Hawks are coached by Tyler Redeau. And now let's meet the starting lineup for your Oswego Buccaneers. On attack, a senior, number 12, Madison Buller. On attack, sophomore, number 5, Katie Fierro. On attack, junior, number 24, Jordan Hare. On attack, junior, number 16, Reagan Thompson. Midfielder, senior, number 3, Maddie Taylor. Midfielder, junior, number 4, Lauren Deviney. Midfielder, senior, number 8, Hannah Coster. On defense, senior, number 17, Cassandra Romeo. On defense, junior, number 26, Monica Cahill. On defense, junior, number 13, Sophia Green. On defense, sophomore, number 2, Nicole Anthony. And in the goal, sophomore, number 23, Abigail Yurkov. The Buccaneers are coached by Ted Beers, assisted by Mark Fierro.
As a part of the opening ceremonies, it looks like the girls will be presenting a sweatshirt all signed by the team.
At this time, if you please give your attention to the center of the field on the track, we please have Mr. Tim Wink report down to the track. On behalf of the girls' varsity lacrosse team, as well as the boys' varsity lacrosse team and the tennis team, we have a few gifts to pass along to Tim. The boys couldn't give the box to Tim last evening, and unfortunately tennis is away today. So in honor of Michelle, we'd like to have Tim accept these gifts.
Trent, this is a really emotional start to this game.
Yes, it is a very special tribute to the friends and families of Michelle Wink. Moments away before the opening phase for what should hopefully be an exciting matchup.
Definitely, I think the girls will definitely be using this tribute as fuel to win this game for Michelle.
Thank you.
And here we go. I think it's Maddie Taylor going for the faceoff. And we're underway.
Square looks like they win the face off in an excellent offensive attack to start off.
Bucks are looking to stop this attack to prevent them from scoring an early goal. Central Square passing it around right now. Oswego looking pretty compact in the defense.
Central Square trying to measure up.
Oswego putting some pressure on.
Under attack, ball is loose. Scooped up. Oswego has it.
Foul on Central Square, Oswego retains possession.
Push first, out of bounds. Adagakeo will start. Post it on the midfield line. Here we go. Oswego starts off attacking quick.
Monica breaking fast down the line.
Ball loose, but still in field.
Madeline Taylor taking it. Loose ball. Oswego keeps possession. Central Square with some good defense takes back the ball. Looking to make their way up the field. Foul on Maddie Bullard. Central Square looking to drive here. Shot. And Central Square keeps the ball. Oswego just trying to stay compact here, stop Central Square from scoring. And Central Square scores. I'm sorry, they did not score. Looks like there is a foul.
Looks like there's going to be a penalty shot here, Tyler.
It's a good opportunity, and Central Square scores. I think what happened there, Trent, is Central Square isolated one of Oswego's defenders, causing them to have to do some last-ditch defense, and then that caused the foul,
yeah,
leading
the foul
to the penalty.
Foul occurred inside the arc.
Tough start for Oswego.
So far, as we're almost 4 minutes into this game, one of the comparisons between these two teams now is that they're very on the offensive, they're rushing quickly on the offensive attack, but then they start to gain some patience, trying to find the right moment to execute a goal. And so far, Central Square, in the first goal of the game, this one is going to try to do it.
Central Square goal scored by number 11, Emma Robinson.
Emma Robertson was the one with the goal for Central Square. Looks like they're looking for the pass from Maddie Taylor, but just off the mark.
And you mentioned about Emma Robinson. She's going to be one of the key players for Central Square. She is the leader for the most points and goals for Central Square. She will be one of the key factors tonight.
They definitely need to mark her then. She's already got one goal in this game. They don't want her to score too many more, and here she is again. Here's that patience you were talking about, Trent. Just looking for the right spot to drive in. Anna Koster with a steal, and she is flying down the field. Looks for the pass.
Like I said, Tyler, quick offensive attack is what these two teams are doing right now. It looks like there's a whistle.
And there's a foul. This looks like a really good chance for Oswego.
Central Square got in a penalty shot. Let's see what happens after this foul.
Maddie Bullard with it. Let's see if she can execute this. And a great save by the goalkeeper for Central Square.
No.
And another foul in Oswego's favor. Oswego retains possession, a good hustle to keep that ball. Good pass into the middle.
They're gonna cut off. Central Square's trying to knock the ball out. Here's the attempt. Looks like it's a pushing call, and it's gonna be Central Square's ball, Tyler.
Good hustle, Sam. Good hustle.
I think it's our ball, actually. Trent, it looks like a penalty shot here. Now Central Square has the ball driving up the field, trying to get into their offensive third. Nice pass into the inside, and it ends up behind the goal. Central Square keeps the ball. And another good pass into the inside, another goal by Central Square. Another tough break for Oswego.
Goal scored by number 4, Emily Brunner. Buccaneer goal scored by number 10, McKinley Thompson.
Yeah, if you want to. I'll see you.
Another tough break from Oswego there. We had the ball in the final third for quite a bit. We just couldn't capitalize on our chances.
Now they have to come back. Now they're going to have to score two goals. But one of the things that I saw in that penalty shot that Regan Thompson take after that missed shot, it was good awareness by Jordan Aaron, number 24, from the Buccaneers.
That's a third goal scored by number 9, Brianna Donahoe.
Yeah, she was in a really good position there.
And then the pass was to a different player. Though. Looks like we got a whistle.
Looks like a little confusion on the field, but it is Oswego's ball. I believe that's Monica Cahill that has it right now. She passes it up to Maddie Taylor, and now Maddie Taylor is driving up the field. Drives past two defenders, takes a shot, and scores. A beautiful goal from Maddie Taylor. 3-2 Central Square.
The difference that time is that they were knocking out patients. They had an open lane. As they were heading inside, Maddie Taylor found a lane inside, able to score a goal that quick. And now they're down by one once again.
She did a really good job there of taking advantage of that open lane that she saw. And wow, what a great start. A great start, yeah, after getting scored on. That's a great way to retaliate there. About 30 seconds after the goal, and they've got another goal, so now it's 3-2.
Buccaneer goal scored by number 3, Manny Taylor.
I think it's going to be Central Square ball right there. Ball right there.
Who have you got? You got the ball.
I say.
drives and shoots, but a nice save by Sudo's goalie. Minutes left in the half. Really good defense from Oswego there. As soon as that runner came in, there was two girls on her, not allowing her to get a shot.
And another good save, but there's a foul.
Looks like a push on one of Oswego's defenders.
It's a penalty shot. And remember, the first goal of the game, Emma Robinson came from a penalty shot. I think this time it's Brianna Dunham taking a penalty shot.
And a great save from the goalie. Oswego looking to capitalize on the counter attack. Maddie Taylor just off the mark with her shot, but Oswego retains possession.
You know, this was a nice running attack on the offense. Just perfect awareness, trying to find a person in the open area. Just a really good effort from Oswego.
Oswego being patient here, trying to find a good opportunity. Reagan Thompson is really being pressured here.
Yeah, she's going to need a pass. She just doubled up, but it looks like she has an open lane in front.
Come on. Ball's in the air.
And Buccaneers still have it. McKinley Thompson, I believe, now played along.
Oswego being real patient here, trying to find a good opportunity. And Jordan Harris scores. She isolated the defender 1v1, did a good job to beat her, and took a really nice shot there to beat the goalie.
Absolutely. That shot was on top, below the crossbar, went in, and we're tied at 3. Question is, can the Bucks get the lead for the first time tonight?
Yeah, we've done a really good job of overcoming adversity here. Down 3-1, I believe. And now we're back to 3-3 on level terms. Let's see if we can use this momentum and keep going forward.
Right, momentum is the key between these two teams. Is Oswego the favorite so far as we're over under 11 minutes remaining? See what happens. Depends on the face-up. The Central score has won it.
It's been a very even matchup so far.
Their goal scored by number 24, Jordan Hare.
And Central Square scores 4-3. As you can see, it's very important to win those face-offs, get that possession after the goal. And that's exactly what they did, and then they got another penalty shot. And
you know what also amuses me, Tyler, is the fact that 3 out of 4 goals from Central Square so far have been scored on penalty shots.
Yeah, I think maybe that's something Oswego's defense need to work on a little bit. We're following them a little bit too much.
Absolutely, they're going to need to adjust defensively. There's still a lot of time, though.
10 minutes left in the half.
Best team
fighting for the ball, and Central Square comes up with it. This is a pivotal moment here in the game. Central Square scores another one here. It might be hard for Oswego to come back. Central Square patiently waiting for an opening. Looks like a charge on Central Square. Crowd wasn't too happy with that decision.
I thought it looked like an embellishment to me as well. Eddie Bowler now with the ball.
Move the ball!
Looks like it's going to be a penalty shot for the Oswego Buccaneers.
We haven't done so great capitalizing on these so far.
Lauren DeVinny going to take the penalty shot, try and tie this game at 4.
And we've got a whistle. It's important for Oswego to capitalize on these chances because Central Square has been. And now it's Central Square's ball. I'm not sure what happened there. Maybe it was a false start or something. I'm not too up to date on the rules.
No question, both teams offensive and defensive.
That's something they're going to have to adjust for the second half.
There's about 4.5 minutes left. Now both teams are fighting for the ball in the midfield. Tight defense and tough to score.
Let's go, Sam!
Inside to Maddie Taylor, she looks to take a shot, takes a turn, another turn, three defenders on her. And we've got a whistle here.
Some type of push on Central Square. Oswego's gonna get a penalty shot. And again, another good opportunity to tie this game up.
Maddie Taylor takes a shot and shoots it by the goalie.
Oh, stop, give it to her!
We're still recording,
to that defense. So. I saw the defensive formation, Tyler, what Central Square had, and it looks like they're taking a timeout. But what I saw from the defensive formation, they had one player in the front and then two players in the middle and then two in the back. Almost looks like as if it was a B formation. And I didn't feel too optimistic about how they're going to afford that to try and afford a tying goal right there. So I thought that was very interesting, what I saw right there.
Yeah, I think really what they're trying to do is stop that inside run, because as we've seen, that's been pretty deadly for both teams.
Yeah. How about those goalies? I mean, despite the penalty shots, that have been absolutely a nightmare for them. They've been warriors.
Yeah, some really good saves.
Thank you. to score before the game. That would be a good way to conclude the first half, but right now they got to pay attention on defense.
Going to sign off for the half. Thank you for watching.
What?
That's all cute.
Jackie, what'd you do?
I always think of it, Mark.
Oh. I was like, Jackie, you're a little paranoid there.
That was nice.
I fell.
I have no idea what I'm talking about.
What?
I have no idea. I often tried to do commentary on Twitch. You've heard of Twitch,
yeah.
Video game thing. I tried to do that, and sometimes the things I say are just beyond ridiculous.
I don't know anything about lacrosse.
You can at least make it. I mean, unless you want to, you know, you want to be the color commentator, you know, play by play. Elbow, there's charging, there's blocking, pushing, slashing, hooking.
Put it a five, I'm sorry.
Yes, I made it with plenty of time.
Pounding. And sometimes fisting.
Yeah.
you in that room, but I can have them.
Where's Lila?
Second half here at Riverfield. Trent Wilson alongside Tyler Jones. We're again set for the second half. What do both teams have to adjust?
I think we did a pretty okay job withdrawing in the first half. We have really capitalized on them. While Central Square has done a really good job capitalizing. So I think the thing Oswego may have talked about is giving them a few less fouls, a little more containing, a little less hitting them when they get close, because they've proven that they're very good at scoring.
Absolutely, and as I mentioned, 3 out of 4 goals came from penalty shots for Central Square. We're seconds away for the face-off for the second half, and we're underway. There we go, a slap. Second's going to be Monica Cahill on the foul in Central Square. On the offensive attack.
Yeah.
allow for central players, plays a Jordan there. They're looking to tie up the Oswego Buccaneers. Looks like Oswego is going to be patient as they play on Central Square's territory. Oswego trying to tie this game up. They're down by one. Early to the second half.
Persistence is key because that goalie, although she's been making good saves, she can't make
seconds. We're about to have exactly 20 minutes left in the second half. The Buccaneers are down by one.
No, I'm not.
And he's going to be scooped up and collected by Central Square, and they will go into the attack. And a foul will be called on Jordan Aaron. The moment Central Square got to the offensive zone. Robinson scored 2 points tonight, looking to get her hat trick. Ball loose and picked up. Monica Jales got it. Looks like we got a whistle here.
Foul on Central Square.
Central Square will have the ball in play. Attacking zone. She passes and it's wide.
Clever play there. I think we all were expecting a shot. And she made a quick pass. Unfortunately for them, they couldn't skip it up.
Now, I'm not sure if one of her teammates recognized it. The pass was going to her. Meanwhile, Swigo has the ball. Enough time. It looks like the goalie's going to go serious with this though. This is a touch. It's touched by Jordan.
Big mom,
look at Swigo. Yes! Yeah! Oh my god. It was a foul before the shot got in. Yes, there was. Lucky break for Central Square. McKinley Thompson, can she tie it? Yes! Tied up at five.
Five. Swigo's showing some great character coming in back throughout the game.
You know what, Tyler? That's the second time that Swigo has come back. Two goals down. What a game we've got. So far, they haven't led the game. They're trying to get their first lead right here. Otherwise, we will go to sudden death.
Maddie Taylor is back on the field.
One of the impact players for the Buccaneers.
Definitely, and we can't forget that break where we on the power that started with Jordan Hare in the midfield running up through and passing it off there with the Thompson, who scored but was fouled, and then she scored again.
Buccaneer goal scored by number 10, McKinley Thompson.
We're going to break that tie again.
Oh yeah,
play the ball against the Hawks territory. Got so dry after the ball, and Central Square still has it. Still got that ball set up, but here's a shot. just joined us here, missing a heck of a game right here on the field. Just recently, Central Square scored in 6 points. I can imagine the man-by-man formation for Swigo is not working out well.
Yeah, it's tough because those 1v1s, if you beat that defender, there's no going back and they get a shot on the goal. It's really just tough to play. She's taking a lot of shots and she's made some good saves.
And I think we figured out the answer as well as to how the Buccaneers offense need to get by the goal.
Yeah,
she made great saves in the first 5 minutes of this game.
Yeah, she has. They've done a really good job driving. What was working was waiting for that person to run in the middle and receive the ball and shoot. But after a while, Central Square's defense got activated to that. So during this half, that's doing a lot of driving. And while the goalies made a lot of really good saves, we can avoid that. We just have to keep going. Persistence is key. And I think we've shown that.
16 minutes, 14 seconds remaining in the second half. Amount of time. Buccaneers are trailing down by one.
Please down three, ready? 1, 2, 3, wait!
Back 3-1 to tie the game, and they did it 5-3. They're trying to tie once again.
And during their huddle, they just kind of winked on three, so they're really
absolutely. We just missed Lauren Davini give out the opening speech to this game.
Central Square goal scored by number 21, Corky Zahn.
Central Square territory.
Defenses so far for Oswego, they're trying to save it.
This benefits the Buccaneers, and Central Square will go patient for at least 30 seconds.
There's a shot, a great save. It looks like there's a whistle.
Yeah.
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 Central Square goal scored by number 4, Emily Brunner.
Say you double team at least the ball carrier, Tyler. I gotta imagine, because it looks like that man-to-man defense is not working out well.
I think after
also
scoring three goals, we'd want to make sure that she can get on the ball.
Also gonna need to win faceoffs as well for the Buccaneers.
Central Square goal scored by number 11, Emma Robinson.
Got it. Works her way into Central Square's territory. Came back. Two down twice. But do you think time is on the essence right now? We're halfway into the second half. She's been a warrior tonight when it comes to face-offs, trying to catch the ball off the face-off.
Buccaneer goal scored by number 3, Maddie Taylor.
Had it. Let's go ball up to Oswego. Oswego. Scored a goal recently by Maddie Taylor, who's taking the ball. Alongside Tyler Jones, we have exactly 10 minutes remaining.
to a 3-goal game.
I really don't think the score is in particular how close this game has been, because so many goals have been
scored. This has been the 7th. Very interesting that the managers decided to stick with that defensive 7th.
Conservative.
they're looking in front. This is it wide.
Looks like we have a timeout here. Oh, a yellow card.
This is odd.
We get the first yellow card of the game. Looks like a shot. And the penalty box for, I guess, 2 minutes. Missed it wide. Scooped up.
Was down 9-6 moments ago. Now it's 9-8, and you're right.
Oswego has yet to take the lead in the game, although it's been a close game the entire match.
Absolutely. What a game we've got. Give you statistics on the score.
They're trying to win in honor of Michelle Wink and her friends and family, since there's a opening ceremony earlier today.
Yeah, it was a beautiful ceremony, and the win to honor Michelle.
All right, here we go. 4:31 to go. As we mentioned, the face-offs have got to be the key.
Yeah, and Central Square has done a really good job of the face-offs. But in the last few weeks, we've been
a miracle score by number 4, Lauren Divini.
It looks like Central Square is really good.
I know.
excellent defense right here.
Yeah,
okay. We need to stay alive in this game.
Central Square is looking to get another goal and make this last shot.
Looks like a slip right there for one of the attackers.
Driving. She's hit hard by number three.
Looks like Watt will stop McKinley Thompson in the head. That's the second time we've seen her.
What's the release on that, man?
Yeah, that's what happens when you really try to drive this defense and try to stop it. She's very brave to keep driving.
To go. Time is on the essence right now. First, we got
they just need more goals. I think that's probably what their coaches are telling them right now. They might be feeling a little tired towards the end of the game, but I think they're going to try to motivate the team to get them more goals.
Yeah.
to go. Buccaneers trying to stay alive. And another foul. Last pick of the minute.
This could be, turn out to be one of the most important possessions of the game here.
Yeah, the next possession as well, Tyler. Just where they're looking for a lead.
What about?
They're looking to engage.
Take it!
Here it comes! What a foul!
Oh, even!
Has been really dangerous on these penalties. Let's see if they can capitalize here.
1:10 to go.
Go, Lexi! Oh,
take the ball.
Not too hot, not too cold. It's very clear.
Okay. Absolutely. We've had beautiful weather here today. Clear skies, temperatures almost around the 70s. We got an update right now. The Buccaneers are
time to try and win this for Michelle Wink, friends and family. They have not led in this game. What can they do?
Just all of you know, watching at home, every time the play stops, the clock stops as well, so it's not a running
time. I'm shaking. Are you ready?
This is so
face-off won by Monica Cahill.
She's surrounded by defenders, manages to get by all of that, and follows.
2-48 here in overtime. Double teamed, and that was clean, and she picks it up. As push, and another foul called on Central Square.
Looks like she might try to switch it here again and lost it.
2:40 to go. Loose ball. Here costs her head for a moment.
Go pick it up, the ball.
And it belongs to the Buccaneers. 2:36 in overtime. They play it back to Monica Cahill. She's a push.
Hold your face.
And then this is the fourth foul in the last 28 seconds.
Again, trying to make these defenders, and she does. Now we're in the final third.
Take your time.
Coach is young to take
this one.
Absolutely.
Great. Oh,
the papers in the up.
Get it.
Get it.
Oh, this one. Yeah, that was Reagan.
That was Reagan. Reagan time.
So, overtime win, there's no way.
One of the best people
in Sweden.
That's the best game we've
ever had. Buccaneers all score by number 16, Reagan Thompson.
What did you do to your wife?
Retired. Retired. Jumbo said, sign off on Wilbur Field.